first got started and introduced into my sport at around the age of 11. It was at primary school, actually. I was just leaving primary school and my teacher got me involved in like sports days and across countries. And she said, she saw something in me, she said, I think you need to join a club. So didn't look back, joined a club at Mile End, Tower Hamlets, Victoria Park Harriers. And the rest is history. My training, I would say the word is intense. Obviously I'm a 400 meter athlete, so it's all about having the base fitness, good endurance, speed endurance, having a bit of speed, power. It's a big group of stuff that kind of gets me ready for when it comes to competition time. My diet, I would say, I'm gonna use the word balanced. I know some athletes may be very specific in what they eat, but I must tell you something. Recently, my fiance, he's turned pescatarian, and obviously, cooking at home, it's like, well, if he's cooking, it's gonna be fish, and I love my fish. So my diet, in terms of intake of protein, I get a big source from fish, so I'm kind of a half-hearted pescatarian because I do like my meat. To stay healthy, the best way is being prepared. You know, it's easy to, you know, pop into a shop and go and buy unnecessary snacks. Don't get me wrong, I love snacks. But if I'm prepared, like I am today, I'm looking forward to my salmon and avocado after that session. It does help to prepare, but for me, that's not always the case. So pre-competition, you're very nervous. You're usually really nervous. You're not really, in terms of having appetite, it's very, very small. But I do love a bowl of porridge because that will sustain me, you know, throughout the day. You know, slow releasing energy, so it'll hold me out. Afterwards, oh gosh, I'm all about my pasta. A big carb, you know, intake after kind of anything with a good taste is going down me. My recovery, a big thing for me is sleep. Just having that kind of downtime, just having that little nap. You know, my naps can be like 15 minutes to a sleep, which is like an hour and a half. But sleep is a big thing, recovery is a good big thing for me, and just eating well. And also treatment, you know, getting that massage or that ice bath, they're really key things to keep me in good nick. Well, especially when I'm doing sessions when I'm by myself, got the headphones on, I love listening to a SoundCloud mix because usually I'm hearing some underground music that I don't usually get to hear often, and it's, you know, continuous. It's not me trying to think of a playlist, it's already done for me, and it's always got to be some funky house or garage. Ooh, I do love a bit of squats. I just like leg workouts, and I like the feeling of when you feel like jelly or when you've got DOMS the next day, because to me you just have that feeling that you know you've worked hard. Least favourite gym exercise, anything to do with arms. My arms were not built to be pulling myself up and things like that, not at all. So when we're talking about dumbbells, kettlebell swings and all these, I'll do it because I know it benefits me, but I really don't enjoy it. Someone that I really get good advice from is Christine Ugu. I mean, Christine trained at the same track as me from East London. She's a 400 meter athlete and she's achieved big things, and she's very knowledgeable. So if I ever need advice or anything to look up to, Christine is definitely the one. God, it's gotta be my family. My family are my biggest fans. I tell you what, I don't even have to, you know, let people know who I am, or, you know, if they do it for me. They're like, all right, it's all right. Well, they'll tell the whole world, but it's because they're proud of me and I do love it. Greatest achievement of my life so far is definitely making the London 2012 Olympics. Making the Olympics at your home games, not many people can say that. And the fact that it was so local to me, I'm very proud. So definitely my biggest achievement.